Okay, I'm going to tie our piece of angle iron off again, and I'm going to do it two times. I'm going to do it once with the blue rope and once with the white rope. And I'm going to tie it first with the bowline at this end and then the bowline at the other end to where I'll make the knot up on that side. In this demonstration, I'm not going to tie the two ropes together. I don't think that's necessary to see that. I want to show the bowline, the alpine butterfly, and then the half hitches, because I haven't discussed the half hitches yet, which is the way you tie the rope off at the end to, you know, keep it from losing tension. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is we just want to tie a simple bowline around this pipe rail here on this trailer. And remember, we don't have to form the loop in the rope, because we're going to use my shortcut, where all you do is just create the shortcut in one motion. And it allows you to really tie the bowline up close and tight to things too, like this too, without a real big loop in it. Okay, so now I'm going to wrap it around our angle iron. And now I'm going to tie the alpine butterfly. So there it is. So that's what we're going to draw our knot off of. So I'm going to pass underneath the pipe rail again. And it does not matter how much tension you put on this, that knot will not slip. And if you wanted to pull it in the other direction, it would not collapse either, unlike a lot of other mid-length knots, loops, which are always going to be inferior to this. So now I can just get this ratcheting mechanism going. What I want to do now is tie this off, but keep the tension. And that's just going to be done with a series of half hitches. And whenever you have this kind of loop like this, or where the rope is spread apart like this, half hitches are even better, because see, as you put the half hitch in, it pinches the rope and even puts more tension on it. So a half hitch is just like you were tying a regular knot, but instead of coming through, you're just letting it drop back down onto itself. See, now to get rid of the extra rope, I can pass up underneath here, and then I can just tie some half hitches back the other direction. So it just makes for a real nice, tidy way to finish things off where you don't have a bunch of rope dangling. Nothing to trip over, and that won't, you do a transcontinental road trip with this and it will not loosen up. Okay, so now I want to, I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to tie it from this end. I'm going to start off at this end. So the first thing that I want to do is tie the bowline in the end. So we're going to use our bowline shortcut. See, and I'm going to tie this real tight and close, which would be hard to do with the loop. So we're forming the loop just in our knot. There it is. Now I'm going to do the alpine butterfly. Okay, I just barely have enough rope. You'll see how much it'll take the tension out of it here in a second. I can just close this off with some half hitches. That's done. And then look how easy it is to just break this apart. The half hitches are so easy. Okay. how easy it is to undo these half hitches. And a lot of times, and you'll see, like in where people want to really make sure that this stays, is they'll take this and they'll just wrap whipping light rope or twine around this to make sure that, you know, on a long sea voyage or something, that this wouldn't loosen up a little bit. But for just, you know, our standard applications, this is always fine. So we're gonna go over our knots one more time, the four knots that we worked on today. So with the bowline is where you come over, and we're gonna form the loop in one motion. Then the knot just passes around the standing part and then back down through the hole. And that's all there is to it. So we don't have to do the thing where we form the loop and the knot and then try to visually pass it up through it. We just, in one motion, we're forming the loop, having it ready to pass around, and here we go. Now we're going to tie two knots together, two ropes together with a sheet bend. We'll have the big one with the loop in it, and you just pass the rope up through it. And remember, use your index finger to create that to hold the rope up so you have a really quick place to pass it through. There you go. There's two ropes tied together of different sizes. And we'll go ahead for safety's sake, if we wanted to do the double sheet bend, we pass it around using our index finger to keep that loop open. And what we do is we just keep that loop open and then just pass it a second time. And this one always kind of needs a little bit of dressing up at the end to make it look just right. But there's your double sheet bend. Now your alpine butterfly is what you would tie in the middle of a rope. So you have the rope draped over the top of your hand. You saw me kind of fumble with this a little bit, but that's okay. You know, I got things kind of mixed up a couple times. So you have it draped over the top of your hand. You just pass it over once. You cross the ropes, pull that piece down, and there's your knot. So that's a loop that you can tie in the middle of a rope that you can pull. Doesn't matter how much you pull on it in either direction, the knot's not gonna collapse, and it's not gonna become a noose. It's not gonna cinch up on you. And in this bigger, nicer rope, it's pretty easy to untie. But let me do it in that thinner rope too, so you can kind of just for. So you drape the rope over your hand just one time, cross the ropes. There you go. So there's your alpine butterfly, the shortcut. Okay, now for a half hitch, you need pretty much a standing part, so I'm going to go ahead and tie this off to the other end over here so I can demonstrate the half hitch again. So I'll just tie a bowline here in the end, you know, just like we've done. So the shortcut method where you pass over, wrap, form the eye in one motion, you're done. So here's the half hitch now. This is without anything other than just some tension on it. So it's very, very simple knot to tie. So you can hold your tension, and as soon as you put that bite on it, the tension stays. And you can form them just one after another really, really quickly. So it's just as though you were tying a knot, but instead of cinching the knot up, you pull the knot back down and it forms a locking place on the standing part of the rope. I tie these like this because they're so easy to tie and to untie, and it's just a really good way to manage the excess part of your rope. See, now you can tie it, now you can get them really far apart too, so you can really, you know, just make sure that your everything is really tidy, that it's not down in the on the dirty trailer. And this wasn't really tying to anything, this was just showing that half hitch. But then look how easy each one is to come undone. But the tension isn't released until you actually take it off. So it still holds tension as long as the rope is passing this way. It's just a real good way to take up slack at the end of the ropes and to keep tension on knots. So let me put a little tension on it and let me do it again. You don't even have to have it pass all the way through either. Look at that. So we'll just leave that in there like that. We can have the double slack of the rope taken up there in the half hitch too. I think it's always best to let it come all the way. But now look, if you want to take it up, you can make your spacing very big. So if you want to get that rope managed really quickly, you don't have to tie them real quick. So when you're using these half hitches, one of the great things about them is you can manage the excess end of your rope after the knot is tied. So here, let me just put one half hitch in here to hold that little bit of tension that I have on that. And then say I had a whole bunch of rope. Well, now look, look how the distance you can make these. You can manage your rope really quickly.